Time for Money Talk, brought to you by our friends at NuMark Credit Union. Today, oh, this is timely, considering inflation and everything else. Strategies and ways to save. I need this big time. So we're going to welcome our guests here in just a couple moments. I do want to remind you, whatever a fantastic future looks like for you, NuMark Credit Union can help you get there faster. Grow your savings with their CD IRA rate special at 3.25 APY for 13 months. Wow, that's a great deal. Open your CD IRA today. Call 815-729-3211 or visit a NuMark office near you. NuMark Credit Union is federally insured by the NCUA. At the end of the program today, we're going to be giving away a $25 Visa gift card, compliments of NuMark Credit Union. How do you win? Well, you listen to my conversation with Mack Story, and we'll say several different things that will be like, whoa, that's a great idea, or whoa, I didn't know that. I'll ask you to repeat one of them in the form of a question coming up at the end of the program. If you're the correct caller at 815-254-7300, you could win or will win a $25 Visa gift card. Mack Story is the Assistant Vice President of Branch Operations, and he joins us on the Turk Furniture Studio line. Hey there, Mack.
Hey, Scott, how's it going?
Awesome. Thanks for coming on. We appreciate it, as always. And, man, this is right on the mark today. Ways to save with interest rates going up, of course, and the Fed meeting again today to discuss, and with inflation and everything high and high energy bills and gas bills, saving is a good idea, my friend.
Huh. Absolutely.
Absolutely right. So I'm going to be listening intently like I do every week, but even more closely this week. So, Mack, before we get into our strategies and ways to save money, tell us about yourself and your role at NuMark Credit Union.
Okay. Well, my name's Mack Story. I've been at NuMark Credit Union now for about 9 years. I am the Assistant Vice President of Branch Operations, so I make sure the branches are running properly and following procedures and that kind of stuff. But yeah, looking forward to being here.
Branches. How many branches are there for NuMark?
We have nine. Nine
wow.
Right now.
Nine. No good. That's growing. That's for sure. All right, well, let's get into money management. So let's just start with some general advice that you would give anyone who's trying to save.
I would say that the first thing that you can do to save money is to always pay yourself first. Make it a habit to put money aside every paycheck, even if it's $5, even if it's $10, whatever you can afford, put something aside and pay yourself first. Put that money in a savings account, or you can even put that money into a higher interest rate CD. As you said earlier, we have a CD special right now at 3.25, so that's very competitive in the market today. So get that money into that CD or a savings account that has a higher interest rate, you know, but always pay yourself first. That's the first thing is once you start doing that and you get in that habit, they'll start building that savings and it'll grow over time. And before you know it, you'll have a little nest egg sitting there.
Yeah, it's kind of like that old, Christmas club account, right? Where you just let it grow. So let me ask you a question, because 401k is beautiful, because other than the pre-tax and so on and so forth. But can I get money taken out of my check if I have an account at NuMark? Can I get money taken out of my check and that goes right into savings so I don't even see that it's gone?
Of course, yes, we can definitely set that up. And so when your payroll hit, your direct deposit comes in, and we can mainly it'll go in checking. But then if you want, $25 or whatever a paycheck going into that savings, we can definitely transfer that automatically for you. So it's kind of out of sight, out of mind kind of thing.
That's the best way to do it. It's painless. It really is.
Exactly. Right.
So
it's done every time.
Exactly. Absolutely. You're not going to I'm going out of town this weekend. I'm going to not put that $100 in. I'm going to go spend it in St. Louis or something like that. Mack, difference between savings and a CD, which stands for a certificate of deposit. Can you kind of get into detail on those two, please?
Yes. So your savings is a regular savings. You can put money in, take money out anytime you need to, that kind of thing. You can kind of, it's liquid and it's there for you to touch and everything. a certificate of deposit is actually locked in for a certain term. So our terms start at 6 months and they go to 60 months. So that's 5 years. But you would put that money in that CD, but you can't touch it for that term. Now, if there's an emergency and you need to break the term, you can definitely do that. You will lose a little bit of interest because of the penalty that's associated with taking money out of the CD. Okay. And everything. So we always say, if you want to open a CD, make sure it's money that you don't need right away. Okay. You know, and you're saving it for a certain goal and you put it in for that certain term.
Okay. That makes good sense. Makes a lot of sense. So IRAs, CDs, mm-hmm. and savings. So talk about the differences from an IRA, CD, and a savings account.
So an IRA is an individual retirement account. That is an account that you set up and you put money in that as you're working. You do have to have earned income. So it has to be money from working a job or some kind of earned income. And you put that in your IRA. There are limits on how much you can put in an IRA each year. I believe right now it's $7,000. You can only deposit $7,000 for the whole year. But then you're saving it for retirement. So once you retire, then you can start accessing that account and everything, but you can't touch it before then. There are some emergency conditions where the government will allow you to take money from your IRA. I'm not going to go into the weeds there with that, but and everything, but there are benefits to having that IRA, because sometimes, and you'll have to check with a tax advisor, but sometimes you do get a break on your taxes if you have an IRA account, depending on how much you have in it. So it's a benefit all around. Once you turn age 72, then you have to start taking money out of that IRA. The government actually says you have to start taking either monthly, quarterly, annually, or something like that. You have to start taking money out of that IRA. That's different from your CD and your savings, because your CD and your savings you can touch pretty much anytime you want without any IRS penalties. If you take money out of the IRA too soon or before it's time for retirement, then you will run into some IRS penalties and everything for using that funds. So, but like you said, a 401k is really good. That comes right out of your paycheck. So you do save for retirement that way. But an IRA is just another way to save for retirement.
Okay. All right. You mentioned the age 72. You must start taking money. Not that you're a politician and voted on this or anything like that, but why? They just don't want the money to stay parked. They want to getting back into the economy at some point.
I'm not sure why they did that, to be honest with you, but I just know that that's the age where they're telling you that, so you need to make sure you've saved for retirement. Now you're at a certain age. Now they want you to start taking that money. It's called a required mandatory distribution. You don't have to take all of it, right, but you do have to take a little bit. It's a percentage of the balance that's in there, and each year that will adjust and everything. But yes, definitely, they do tell you they do tell you that you do have to take it out there at that age.
Interesting. Okay. We're talking to Mack Story. Mack is the Assistant Vice President of Branch Operations for NuMark, and there are 9 different branches. So we talked at the top, Mack, about things are tough right now. They really are, and many people think they'll get worse before they get better. It is hard to save. What are some ways people can avoid paying extra interest and fees on the purchases that they make?
Okay. First one is you want to avoid that extra interest. So try to keep your balance as low on credit cards as if you can. Believe me, I've been in that situation where you got to use that credit card to live 1 month, you know, and everything. So it might get a little maxed out. But try to keep that balance as low as possible. That'll avoid you paying extra interest, because you will pay interest on it every single month. So you're paying interest on that balance every month. So even if you don't get it paid off, you're now paying interest again on the same balance. So if you can get it paid down, also pay your cards on time. Even if it's on the due date and you do it through the app on your phone or whatever, pay it on time. Don't let it go past, because those extra fees are going to add up.
Yeah.
Also, there's a lot of credit cards out there. So look for that credit card that has that zero annual fee card. So that way you're not paying an annual fee to use the card. Now, some cards do have annual fees due to the fact that you perks, so you get the miles, you get the cash back, that kind of thing. So there may be some annual fees associated with that. So just do your research on the card before you apply. And then also look at that interest rate. That interest rate, it can be anywhere. I from 15% all the way up to 30% on credit cards. So just make sure you look at that interest rate.
Okay.
And if you're applying for a new card, look for promotional offers. Sometimes they'll do promotional offers where it's 12 months, 0%, you know, or they'll do 24 months, 0% on balance transfers. And then you can take the balances that are on your higher interest credit cards and you can transfer them over and get 0% for 24 months. And that'll give you a chance to save on that interest and also get that card paid off as quickly as you can because you're not paying that extra interest. When it comes to your checking account, try not to overdraw your checking account and look for checking accounts that have no hidden fees and they offer ATMs that don't charge a fee if you ever need to use that ATM. If you're like me, you probably use your debit card a lot and everything. We do have a checking account here that actually gives you cash back for using your debit card. So come into one of our branches and we can tell you all about it. But try not to overdraw. We know that mistakes happen. Sometimes you forget that a check's outstanding or you forget that you've done something or anything like that. So then this way you can just make sure that you're balancing your checkbook and you know how much money's in there. So that way you're not overdrawing your account and avoiding those fees as well.
Yeah. So there's a lot of mistakes people make when it comes to their finances, Mac. What do you think is at the top of the mountain?
I would say that at the top of it is not having an emergency fund set aside because we do know those emergencies happen. You know, your air conditioner breaks, your furnace goes out, that kind of stuff. And it goes back into that paying yourself first when you get paid. So just you can set up that automatic transfer to go to the savings account. And then when those unexpected costs come up, then you're set. You have that backup plan. You have that emergency fund sitting there waiting. And then the other thing that I can think too about a biggest mistake is paying off the wrong debt first. You always want to pay off the debt that has the highest interest because that's the one that's going to save you money in the long run. You know, you may not think you're getting anywhere and you're spinning your wheel, but as long as you just pay off that higher interest rate credit card or loan first, then you're going to start saving money in the long run. So take a look at that and then go down to the next card or the next loan that's the lower interest rate and keep moving down to the lowest interest rate possible.
Okay. All right. Mac, what advice would you give to someone who's learning how to budget? They're just getting started in this whole big crazy process.
I would say start early and start now. So if you're just starting out on your first job or, you know, and you're just starting out the budgeting, again, make sure you pay yourself first, get in the habit of doing that, and then you're going to set yourself up for that emergency fund or that little savings account that you can rely on if an emergency ever happens. The other thing is to learn to limit yourself. I break down my purchases into necessities, and it would be nice to have. You know, necessities come first, and then whatever I have left over, I can buy those nice things that I want, you know, and everything. But if I don't need it, I try not to buy it, you know, or I'll save for it and then pay for it in cash instead of putting it on a credit card. Other things that you can do is set debit card alerts. A lot of the financial institutions now have what they call e-alerts, where if you use your debit card or your balance drops below a certain balance, you'll get a text message. It'll just tell you, hey, your balance is below this, you know, and everything. So you can keep a track of your checking account. And then try to find a checking account that pays you back. You know, I mentioned earlier here, we have a common sense checking account that using your debit card, you'll actually get a cash back bonus at the end of the month. It's not much, but hey, every little bit helps. If you have a hard time budgeting with a debit card, because if you use your debit card, it's just like a, you know, credit card. So it's coming right out of your checking account though. If you have a hard time with balancing that, then carry cash, because if there's cash in your pocket, then you know that that's your limit. That's all you can spend. And then you don't, you know, have that need to use that debit card or that credit card, you know, carry that cash and that'll keep you at your limit. And then once that cash is spent, then you know you can't spend any more. The rest of it has to go to your bills or to your savings account or anything like that.
Okay. Makes good sense. All right. So let's turn this around and give you a chance to sing the praises of NuMark Credit Union, Mac. How can NuMark help those people out there looking to start a money management plan?
We have 11 employees in our branches that are eager to help you. We can sit down, go over your budget with you. We can help you out and set up a savings plan. We can set up different savings accounts. So if you're saving for certain things, we can do different savings accounts for you. We do have a money management program in our online banking that can help with you and everything. I've used it myself to pay off a credit card. You put in the balance, what interest rate, and then you tell it when you want it to be paid off. And it actually walks you through and tells you how much you need to pay each month to get that credit card paid off in that certain time. So we do have lots of different tools that we can use to help. So I would just say the first step is stop by a NuMark branch and ask to speak to someone about managing budget and that kind of thing. And they can sit down with you. They can go over your budget. All of our branch managers are more than willing to help you out and get you set up on a budget plan.
Great. Absolutely fantastic. Mack, as always, thank you very much for some great information. We really appreciate the knowledge.
Cool. Thanks, Scott.
All right, brother. Take care of yourself. That's Mack Story, Assistant Vice President of Branch Operations at NuMark Credit Union. All right, so now comes the time of the program where I give you a chance to win a $25 Visa gift card. Compliments of NuMark Credit Union. Before we do that, I want to remind you, whatever your fantastic future looks like, NuMark can help you get there faster. Grow your savings with their CD IRA rate special at 3.25 APY for 13 months. Open your CD IRA today. Call 815-729-3211 or visit a new NuMark office near you. NuMark Credit Union is federally insured by NCUA. All right, here's a question. When it comes to an IRA, Mack gave us the number. By what age do you need to start withdrawing some money from your IRA, your retirement account, individual retirement account? What age? First correct caller on the Turk Furniture Studio line, 815-254-7300. Again, that's 815-254-7300. Do you know the answer? Let's find out. Hi, good morning. You're on WJOL. Who's this?
Sherry.
Hi, Sherry. What's the right answer?
72.
72. Exactly right. You probably want a $25 Visa gift card now, don't you?
Yes, I do.
All right. Hang on the line. I'll give you the information. Yep, age 72. Sherry was exactly right. She is the winner of the money, the gift card, the Visa gift card from NuMark Credit Union. Congratulations, Sherry.